Hello everyone and welcome back to Jack Scraps. Thanks for joining me today. I have a Country Craft Creations design team project to share with you, and I will be using Let's Go Camping by Echo Park. Now, I believe I picked this up last year and it just never came about, and the paper collection kind of got lost in other collections. And so this year I thought about it around Christmas time because I have some neighbors who have been bringing me tins of cookie for the Christmas holiday, and I've been graciously thanking them, but I wanted to actually give them a gift as a thank you back this year. So I thought, why not use this collection and create them a mini album because they go camping all the time. So that's what I've created today, and that's what I'll be sharing with you. Before we get started, I did want to mention that Country Craft Creations is having a New Year's Eve crop, and you can access this via a Facebook group, and I will have it linked down below for you, as well as the schedule, so that you can see how many designers are participating in this fun event. It kicks off on Friday and will go through Saturday and Sunday. And it will be a very fun way to bring in the new year. So I hope that you will join us. I actually created a card to go along with that for when I give it to them. And I really just used some of the paper collection here. This was one of the 3x4 journaling cards. I layered it onto some of the decorative paper that I just cut down. And then the background is the decorative paper as well. It says, "Making memories one campsite at a time." It's just perfect. I put it on this craft cardstock base and then added a border strip here at the bottom. So here is the mini album that I created. This is 8.5 by 8.5, and the pages are 8 by 8. The spine is 1 7/8 inches wide. And here is the backside. I added a cute little 2x2, and I actually made this a pocket so you could tuck something down in there. I did use the lay flat binding method. So on the front cover, what I've done is created a pocket along the bottom. I added a 4x4 journal card here on the front that I've layered on some cardstock. And then behind that, I added 2 photo mats, and these are 4x6 photo mats. I actually created my photo mats in InDesign and printed them out on cardstock, and then you'll see what I've done with them on the inside when we get there. So they can just add their photo here, they could do some journaling on the back, or they could add photos on both sides. On the inside, you'll find 4 pages to this mini album, and each of the pages do have a side pocket. On the front inside cover, we have a little pocket here. I put in a 3x4 journal card. It says, "Go take a hike." And then I added one of my 4x6 photo mats. This is on cardstock. And I even put a 2x2 journal card here. This says, "Campers have s'more fun." I thought that was so cute and went perfect with the little star background. There's plenty of room to add more to this pocket. The front of the pocket is an actual flip up. It's a magnetic flip. I've added areas for 2 smaller photos here. You could do 2x2 or 3x3s here. And down below, we have a little tuck spot where I've added a journal card, "Camp more, worry less." So you could add a photo to the back area here, as well as even to the back of the journal card. I really took advantage of the sticker sheet that came with this collection. It had some really great stickers. And on this one, I backed it with cardstock, but most of them I left as is because they had a nice white border around them, which made them really pop from the paper. Okay, here is our first page. We have "Let's Go Off the Grid," and I left a photo area here. This is a pocket, as you can see here, and I put in "Camping is my favorite therapy." You can add a photo to the back. This flips open to the left. It has a magnetic closure. We have another photo mat area here. Now, what I did with the photo mats in the mini album, for most of them, they are on paper, just regular copy paper, and I used Scotch restickable glue stick so that you could remove this image and put in your photo, and then you can just glue that down. But this way, it tells them how to use the mini album. I'm not sure that they're familiar with this type of photo album, so I wanted to provide as much direction as I could to help them out. And on this side, we have two more photo mat areas. These are 3 by 4.5. Now, you can add your photos right to these photo mats, but I would recommend gluing it down with permanent glue just for longevity of the mini album. Otherwise, these can be removed. I use the removable glue on them as well. You'll also see that I continue to use some of these stickers here for decor. So this whole section lifts up. It is also closed by magnets. And then we have a nice 5 by 7 area here for a photo. I used some photo corners. I used the punch, We Are Memory Keepers punch that I picked up from Country Craft Creations. And here we have a large area. You could add a photo, you could add memorabilia, whatever you want to capture. And I added these two little photo corners. You can tuck things in them. Here's another one of the 4 by 4 cards, however you like to use them. In the pocket, we have a nice half pocket here. Again, I use these stickers to decorate a border strip here. And in the back, we have a cardstock 4 by 6 photo mat. And I did this one landscape to provide enough area to add photos in any orientation. And here's another one of the journaling cards, super cute. On the back side, we have another area for two smaller photo mats. And actually, even though this is decorative, you could add a photo here. On this page, we have a little pocket here in the front that says adventure. I really like the way this turned out. I picked this journal card specifically for the way that it worked. And that is, the best days are adventure. But then when you pull it out, it also says the best days are spent camping with you. I don't know. I just really love that this kind of had two meanings here, and it just worked out perfectly. So in this pocket, we have another 4 by 6 journal card, and then I included two cardstock 4 by 6 photo mats. Another fun feature of this is you can see that it's just a plain color here, but when you flip this up, we actually have some stickers decorating the back of the pocket. I love that you can't see it here, but when you flip up, it's like a little surprise. On the top of this pocket, we have a 4 by 6 area for a photo, and then I just used some decorative paper on the side. This is a fun interactive page. We start out with a gatefold, and this says Starry Skies and Fireflies, another 4 by 4 card on some decorative paper. On the back side, I created a 6 by 6 photo mat. Let's open the gatefold, and we have two 3 by 5 photo mat areas. Again, I use the stickers. In the center, I created a little pocket here where I put in two of these smaller photo mats on cardstock. And when we flip this up, we have a nice twist and pop. At the top of the twist and pop, I created a pocket, and in there we have a 4 by 4 that I put on some solid cardstock and another cardstock 4 by 6 photo mat. So you can add your four photos here, and then at the bottom, I added a 4 by 6 photo area as well. Again, this one is on regular copy paper and is removable. Here is the insert for this pocket. We have a long side pocket with a journal card and photo mat. On the back side, we have a 5x7 photo mat area and just a decorative strip here. On this page, we have a really cute 4x6 journal card here, and then this flips up. It's magnetic. This flips open to the left. This flips down, and this flips over to the right. For each of these photo mat areas, I use the Dress My Craft punch where you get the slots so that you could just tuck your photo right into those. We have a nice large area here. Again, you could add a photo or two, and I added this cute little camp sticker. On this page, I just loved all of these stickers here to decorate it. We have two pockets, and they just hold these little tags that I created from the collection. Behind these pockets is a long pocket, and we have a 4x6 photo mat in that. Here's the beautiful paper. The insert for that says, I have a wild side. And on the back, we have two areas for photos. These are 3¼ by 5¼ photo mat and just a decorative strip here. On this page, we have a nice waterfall. I did add the little campground sticker. I used some faux leather here as a pull. And then added one of the 4x6 journaling cards at the bottom, so it would be a nice little surprise as you are pulling down on the photo mats. Now, I didn't add decorative paper to this because I want there to be plenty of room for photos, but on the first one, I did put that this is a 4x6 photo mat. So just to, again, help them out in understanding what these areas are for. This is our last page in the mini album, and I've created like a swing window. And here I added this arrow and then a pull so that they would know to lift this up and pull it. This has a magnetic closure, and when you lift it up and over, it flips to two photo mat areas. Such a fun little interactive element. And then we have this little deer popping around the corner. Lots of fun. Here is the insert for that page. I just added some of the stickers here that spell out camp. We have a 4x6 photo mat, but again, you can put in multiple photos in each of these inserts. It will hold more than one. And on the back side, I created a little collage of photo mats here. And on the back side of that, we have a belly band that is what I'm calling a split belly band because I created two little pockets out of it. In the top pocket, we have this little insert, and inside we have two 3x5 photo mats. Here is the next one, the great outdoors. And this one opens up to a little collage of photo mats as well. We have 2x3s and 3x3 photo mats. I did leave the backside blank on both of these so that they could add their own photos. You know, they could even use a gel white pen to do some writing back there if they wanted to. But these just slip in there. It is separated here in the center. On the back inside cover, I added some of the stickers. And I created a little dimensional pocket here, like a policy envelope. I did add this on three sides so that you could tuck something behind it, which I've added a 4x6 journaling card. And when we open this up, you have plenty of room to add more. This is dimensional, and I've included these journal cards. But you could put maps or just memorabilia from the trip in there. And as you can see here, I did use two of the stickers for the Brad areas. I really just love doing that rather than just having plain little circles. These are much more fun. And that is the mini album. I had so much fun creating this. I hope that they enjoy it, and I hope that you have as well. I will be doing a tutorial on this mini album in the future. I think I might put another project in between it, but just so that you know that a tutorial will be coming for this 8x8, I'm going to call it an 8x8 mini album. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and let me know what you think in the comments. I would love to hear from you. And I'll see you next time.